Welcome back. We are solving some examples as part of functions. Okay, we have simple example. Find the domain and range of f of x equal to x by 2 minus 3x. Okay, now we know that if I have 2 minus 3x equal to 0, then I'll have some value divided by 0 which is not defined, so I cannot have. First I am trying to find out what's the value of domain. So if I go to domain, 2 minus 3x cannot be equal to 0. That means what can I say then? You can say that x is not equal to 2 by 3. So domain is nothing but equal to r minus of 2 by 3. Now interesting to find out range. To find out range in situations where it is not straightforward, what we will do, we will take f of x equal to y and we will say y equal to x by 2 minus 3x. Now what I will try to do is, taking this y, I will try to find out x in terms of y so that I can find out the condition with respect to y which will allow me to define the values for x. Now let me simplify this. If I simplify this, I will have 2y minus 3xy or 3yx equal to x. Now I want to represent y. I want to represent x in terms of y, so I have to get my x out. So I will say 2y equal to x plus 3y into x can be is nothing but 2y equal to x into 1 plus 3y, or can I say it as x equal to 2y divided by 1 plus 3y. Now what we have done, we have been given f of x equal to, now what we are trying to understand is to find out the range. We know that the range comes from the values of y and the domain is nothing but from the values of x. We want to find out what are the values of, if I want to give a value to x, what is the condition I should satisfy with respect to y. Now what I did, I have taken f of x equal to y and I try to get x in terms of y. So what I did is just simplification and I found x equal to 2y by 1 plus 3y. Now you know that x cannot have a value, x is not defined if 1 plus 3y is equal to 0. That means 1 plus 3y cannot be equal to 0. That means y, 3y equal to minus 1, so y equal to minus 1 by 3. So y cannot be equal to minus 1 by 3. That means the range is nothing but equal to all the values of r minus of minus 1 by 3. So this is an interesting method to find out the range whenever you have functions are complicated. What you have to do? Now whatever is given to you, take it equal to y. Now from then onwards, find out what is x in terms of y. Now you will see clearly that what is the condition you should have. Something like here 1 plus 3y cannot be equal to 0. If I want to define x, I have in the denominator value equal to 0. That means 3y can never be equal to minus 1, or y cannot be equal to minus 1 by 3. So the range is nothing but excluding that value minus 1 by 3. Remaining all values are allowed. Let's move. Find the range of each of the following functions. These are very simple ones. F of x equal to 2 minus 3x and the domain is x belongs to R. X is greater than 0. If x is greater than 0, let us say x is 0.001 or something, you will see that this whole thing is negligible, then you will have value 2. So can I say 2, but 2 is excluded because x is equal to 0, then only I will have 2, but x is greater than 0. It can be 0.00001, where it will be almost equal to 2. So I can take 2 as a boundary, but it is excluded. Then afterwards, let us take higher values. If I take x equal to, let us say x equal to 10. If I take x equal to 10, minus 3 into 10, minus 30 plus 2. Now you can see that as the x value is becoming more and more, this 2 becomes insignificant and you are having absolutely altogether negative value. What I mean to say is 2 minus 3x is tending to negative as the x is becoming more and more bigger number. If I take x equal to 1000, this becomes minus 3000 plus 2. That's a very big number, very big negative number. That means 2 is my end point. I have to start with minus infinity because all are negative values. So answer will be, range will be minus infinity to 2. How we have done that? 2 minus 3x, x should be greater than 0. If it x is infinitesimally larger than 0, 0.0001 or something like that, you can see that it's almost equal to 2. For any value more than x should be greater than 0, so take 10 or 100 or 1000, whatever you take, you will see that 2 becomes insignificant and this whole thing is becoming negative term. Negative term means you can go up to negative infinity, so negative infinity to 2. Okay, let's move to the next one. F of x equal to x square plus 2, x belongs to R. Suppose I take x equal to 0. If I take x equal to 0, then one value I can get is 2 in range. Okay, if I take x equal to negative 4, I will have negative 4 square plus 2. That is nothing but 16 plus 2 equal to 18. If I take 4, I have 4 square plus 2. That is also equal to 16 plus 2, 18. That means whatever the value you give to x, either it is positive or negative, since it is squaring the number always returns the positive value, so always x square plus 2 is becoming positive. That means you are starting from 2 and you are going towards infinity, but 2 is included, infinity is excluded. That will be your answer. Let's move at the last one. It's very simple. F of x is x, x belongs to R. So I can simply say that range is also equal to R, because no constraints on domain, no constraints on range also. Those are some simple examples related to functions finding the domain and ranges. Thanks for visiting. See you in the next session. Bye for now.